This is the first module in the solutions chapter, and we're talking here about solution composition, you know, different ways of describing the composition of a solution. We have different units of concentration. You've seen some of them. I know you guys have seen molarity already, but just to review it real quick because it's so important. The molarity of a solute in a solution is defined as being the moles of the solute divided by the liters of the solution. Right here. Just be careful. Remember that's liters and it's solution, it's moles and it's solute here. Or in, you know, symbols, a lot of times we write it like capital M to stand for molarity. It's equal to N, which is moles of solute, over V, which is liters of solution. let's say, you know, just some notation to remind you, the concentration of hydrochloric acid. If we write the square brackets like that, kind of square, that means we're talking about the molarity or the concentration of hydrochloric acid in that particular solution. All right, so that's a review. You should be pretty comfortable with that unit of concentration already. The next one, mass percent. I know you've seen it, but here it is again. Mass percent of a solute in a solution is just the mass of the solute divided by the mass of the solution times 100%. The mass can be in any units as long as it's the same on top and bottom. Grams and grams, kilograms and kilograms, ounces and ounces, pounds and pounds, what have you, okay? So let's do a little example real quickly. Let's say you made a solution by dissolving 1.292 grams of sodium chloride in 23.49 grams of water. What is the mass percent of sodium chloride in that solution? Well, remember the definition is the mass of the solute divided by the mass of solution. And real quickly, just to remind you, I know you know this, solute is what's dissolved, and the solvent is what it's being dissolved in. If it's liquids, then the solute is what there's the least of, and the solvent is what there's the most of. And the solution is the solute plus the solvent. Remember that. That's why when we do this problem right here, because mass percent is mass of solute, the solute is the thing that's being dissolved, sodium chloride, and its mass is 1.292 grams. It's divided by the mass of solution, because the solution includes the solute and the solvent. We have to add those two masses up, mass of the solute plus mass of the solvent. In terms of sig figs, this guy has 4. When we add these, we're looking at places past the decimal, so we get 3 past the decimal. That bottom number, whatever it is, it's going to be 5 sig figs. It's going to be 24.703 or 1 or something like that. Anyway, least is 4. We're dividing. We care about number of sig figs. 4 sig figs here. We get to keep 4. The 100, by the way, is exact. So when you do this, you get 5.2284%. If you haven't seen this notation before, what I do is, because remember you're never supposed to round until the end of a calculation, what I do is I put at least the first one, sometimes two, insignificant figures as a subscript until the very end, right? That way I keep track of the insignificant figures as well as the number of sig figs. So anyway, 4 sig figs, 5.228, first one's 4, because this is less than 5, we just keep it. The answer is 5.228%. You guys should just real quick put it in your calculators, make sure you get the same number as me. Cool. Next, mole fraction. You may have not seen this before, but you're using it. We're using it in the first lab that we do this semester. So the definition. So we have a solution, okay? And let's say that the solute, let's say there's just one solute. It could be more than that. But the A is the solute, okay, and the mole fraction of A in that solution. This is supposed to be a Greek letter chi, chi sub A. The mole fraction of A is defined as being the moles of A in the solution divided by the total moles in the solution. So remember, the solution contains the solute plus the solvent, so we have to add them together on the bottom. I don't know if I have to say this, but make sure you memorize all these, the formulas, definitions. So let's do a little example. What's the mole fraction of sodium chloride in a solution if we made that? You know, the same one, same solution we just were talking about. We dissolve 1.292 grams of sodium chloride in 23.49419 grams of water, right? So solute, solvent. So what we need to do this is we need the moles of sodium chloride and the moles of water. I'm going to add the moles of both of them up for the denominator, just the moles of the sodium chloride on top, times 100%. And remember, to go from grams to moles, all you have to do is divide the grams by the molar mass of that compound. So we do that. Next slide here. So remember, 1.292 grams of sodium chloride. This, you should check me to make sure you get the same number, but 58.443 is what I got for the molar mass of sodium chloride. That gives us that many moles of sodium chloride. That goes in the top here. The water, 23.419 grams divided by the molar mass of water. It gives us moles of water. So the mole fraction of sodium chloride is just the moles of sodium chloride divided by the sum of the moles of both of these. And I get this number. Again, check my work, make sure you get it. 1, 2, 3, 4 sig figs. When we add them, we get to keep 1, 2, 3, 4 past the decimal, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we keep 4 past the decimal, which is 5 sig figs. So we're going to round to 4 sig figs. So I get 0.01672. There's no units, it's just a number. Check and make sure you guys get the same one. Next, I know you've seen this before, but just reviewing. Molality, the symbol is a little m. It's defined as being the moles of a solute divided by the kilograms of the solvent. That's the definition. So watch out, molarity, capital M, is moles of solute, still on the top, but molarity is liters of solution on the bottom. This is kilograms of solvent. So to calculate the molality of this same solution that we've been using, 1.292 grams of sodium chloride and 23.419 grams of water, all we need is the moles of the solute, which is still sodium chloride. And we already calculated that, right? Remember back when we did just a minute ago, we did the mole fraction, we calculated this. So that's the number we got. That goes there. And remember, to go from grams to kilograms, remember all I do is I move the decimal three places to the left. I get 0.023419 kilograms. Sig figs, we have 4 sig figs, 4 sig figs. Do the division, check my work please. Get that. And that's going to round 2, because a 7 is 5 or bigger, we round this up, which makes this a 4. 0.0 molal in sodium chloride. All right, normality. This isn't used as much, that I don't see it as much anymore, but you should know it. It may appear on the ACS, or you may sometimes you see it on bottles in stockrooms, chemistry stockrooms. All right, so normality is related to molarity, right? And the normality depends upon the specific chemical reaction that you're talking about, right? If it's an acid, it's going to be an acid-base reaction. But if it's not, sometimes in redox reactions, which we'll see later this semester, it's different. But generally, the easy way to do it is just to find the molarity and multiply it by the mole ratio from the balanced equation. So let me show you what I mean by that. All right, so we have to know what kind of reaction we're talking about here. This is an acid-base reaction. Phosphoric acid and sodium hydroxide. The mole-to-mole ratio here, that's the important thing. 3 sodium hydroxides to 1 phosphoric acid. So let's say we knew, somehow, the molarity of phosphoric acid, the concentration, was 1.2 moles per liter. Well, the molarity, all you do is you take the normality, all you do is you take the molarity times the mole fraction, times 3 to 1. So we just take 1.2 molar times 3 over 1. It's always the thing it's reacting with divided by the coefficient of the stuff. And we get 3.6 normal. So we would say that that solution is 3.6 normal in phosphoric acid. And there you go.